Everybody wants maintainable and scalable software, but they don't want to put in the extra work to make sure that it's tested so bugs don't get introduced. And a fun fact, 87% of applications don't have unit tests at all. So to separate you from the other 87%, which will put you in the top 13%, is to implement unit tests in your application. That'll allow your application to be secure, allow you to be able to add enhancements quickly, and make your application scalable, maintainable, and have less bugs. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how to implement Pytest and HTTPX to be able to test against client requests and unit tests in Python. So let's dive into the video. All right, so in this video, we are going to be able to write tests for our FastAPI application. So just like we always do, the very first thing we're gonna do is create a virtual environment by doing Python 3-m venv env. Now, this will create a virtual environment for our application where I'm gonna say source env slash bin slash activate. And now we need to install our dependencies. So we can say pip install FastAPI and uvicorn. Once you do that, this will install all the dependencies that we need for our FastAPI application to work correctly. So these yellow lines will go away here momentarily, but in our main.py application, we have our FastAPI application where we have a to-do of name and completed. We have a fake mock database that's going to store all of our to-dos. And then we can get the list of the to-dos, create a new to-do, get a specific to-do based on the ID, update a to-do, and delete a to-do. So if we went ahead and ran this application in our Swagger documentation, we'd be able to run all of these API endpoints. But for the simplicity of this video, let's just go right into how we can test and implement testing for FastAPI. Now, the very first thing that we need to install is HTTPX. And this is a way for us to be able to use a client request to be able to test our API endpoints. So let's go ahead and import this. And now what we need to do is install Pytest. And Pytest is unit testing for applications. So we're going to be able to test and unit test our Python code as well as our API endpoints. So let's go ahead and say pip install Pytest. Now that we have all four dependencies, which is FastAPI, uvicorn, Pytest, and HTTPX, let's go ahead and say new file. And here we wanna name this test underscore main.py. And the naming convention is this, is it's going to start with test. That's how you know it's a test file. And then underscore, and then main, which is the file that we're testing against, dot py. So when we run our Pytest, it's going to look for these test files. Now, the very first thing that we need to do here is just say from fastapi.testClient, import our test client, and then from our .main, import our apps and our to-dos. Now, unlike where we do main app equals fastapi, we want to grab the app, which is FastAPI, from our main and import it into our test client. So we can then go ahead and say client equals test client, where we pass in our app. We then want to set up a function that just deletes all of to-dos. So in this case, it's going to delete all the to-dos from our application, even though it's just a blank list. So you probably want to set up some kind of SQLite external database that will be able to run against this. But as of right now, we'll just say def setup function brackets. And then inside here, I'm just going to say todos dot clear. All right. So what this does, this is before each test, we are just going to delete all of the todos so they don't touch each other. So one test doesn't influence another test. All right. And now the very first thing I'm going to say here is def test read todos. Response, which is our response from our client, which is our test client, dot get, and we're just verifying using assert, and assertions are like true and false to see if it's true or not. Our response code is going to be a 200 when we call just our normal get. And then we also are expecting an empty list. So if we go back here and we look at our get, we can see that it's going to return all of the to-do's values, and it's going to return a status code of 200. But because to-dos list is empty, it should just return an empty list and a status code of 200. And we can go ahead and run this just by typing in Pytest. And immediately we can see that we had one test that was passed. We have two warnings just because it's using some deprecated files. But outside of that, we have our test passing. Now, if for whatever reason your application is crashing right here because it can't find the main functionality, just close VS Code and reopen it. Sometimes it gets lost when you're creating new files. All right, so now that we've done that, let's create another test for creating a to-do where we can just right under here, go ahead and just say def test create to-do, where we're creating our response is equal to client.post. So we're checking our post functionality. We're making sure our JSON has a key of name with a value of buy groceries. We're making sure it's completed and false. And then we want to verify that we get a 200 response back after passing this in, and that the response is just going to be the exact same thing. So if we come over here and we look at our post functionality, we can see that we just add a new to-do to our list. And here we are verifying that once we add it, we can test against it. So let's go ahead and just say Pytest and see that now both of our tests have passed. Now, if we throw another S at the end, now all of a sudden our test does not pass. So if we said Pytest, we can see that we get a fail. And if we scroll up, we can see that it's going to throw an assertion error. Now, this is going to be assert completed of groceries equals completed groceries. So we can see that it does not equal the groceries. And it'll tell you right here. So the differing items is named by groceries is not equal to named.byGroceries with an extra S. So let's go ahead and just change this back to just 1S. So our application passes. We now want to go ahead and test our read to do of a single ID. So we can do this by right under here saying def test read to do with our client.post of just an empty slash. JSON equals name by groceries, completed equals false, response equals client.get/1. So we're passing in 1 as the path parameter. And again, we're just verifying that this is going to equal this. So when we add a new item, you know, we're going to be adding a primary key of 1, and we're just verifying that, hey, that's inside. And I don't think we're actually passing in a primary key. I think it's going to be the first item in the list. So if we say Pytest, we can see that now all three of our tests pass. Let's now go ahead and verify against a post for an update. And right here, let's go ahead and just say test.update, where we're saying client.put request, which we're going to be doing client.post. And this just sets up our client call. And then we can do client.put right here, where we're updating our buy groceries to buy vegetables after we already added in there. So now if we go ahead and say Pytest, we can see that we have all four tests pass. And then lastly, we can do the exact same assertions for our delete to do. So if we come over here now, we say def test delete to do, where we pass in our client of buy groceries. We are then trying to delete that ID or the first element of our list, making sure that we get a status code of 200, and then buy groceries is actually gone within the response. So now if we go ahead and say Pytest, we can see that we get all five tests passing. And this is essentially how you can use Pytest and our test client from FastAPI to A, be able to use assertions to test the unit tests and test the value of the Python business logic. And then also we can use the response and clients to test and validate the API endpoints for our FastAPI application. If you're able to find value, go ahead and click like. If you found value in this video, go ahead and like the video and go ahead and check out one other FastAPI video from my playlist, and I will see you in the next.